Good morning, good evening, good afternoon, everybody. I forgot to turn on my front light. There we go. More like RemyCore now. Yeah, I am basically RemyCore. I mean, look at my background. It's fucking awesome. It's fucking awesome. I love having this as my background. Oh. Also, here's a very special shout out to a certain someone in the chat, because he has just done this. Now I'm accidentally starting up Origin. Fuck! No! Go away, Origin! No one likes you. No! No! Stop! No! Quit! Want to do this one. I have received a gift. Because I really made his evening with my Remy stream yesterday. Maybe play this in a stream. From Adolwin. Also known as Sebastian. He got me A Bird Story, which is apparently a really good game. So, yeah, thank you so fucking much, dude. I really appreciate it. People are buying me games like a motherfucker. Like, stop! I'm feeling guilty because of it. I mean, I'm going to add that to my library then. And now it is right here. A Bird Story. I'm going to add it to my favorites. So I remind myself to play it. So yeah, that is really fucking awesome, dude. Thank you very much. So we are going to do Adine's route today. Now I want to ask, with everything that I have, I'm able to do her good ending, right? What is my Steam? I'll just post it in the chat, but basically, I forgot to buy some bundles in other games. Stop, Night Sky. No, basically my Steam ID is that Metalcore Brony, so if you look up that and you'll find my, my Steam page, which has my, which looks like this. So if you find this, that's me. Okay, so we are going to do some more Angels with Scaly Wings. But like I said, you know, with everything that I have right now, I should be able to get a good ending, right? Oh, I should buy you a PS4 as well? Give us feels and we'll give you games? Oh, look at that. Now everyone's fucking adding me to their friends list. Oops! Oops! Like, now everyone wants to be fucking friends. Jesus. Hang on! You just need the map for Dean? Okay, good. Accept. Yes, I know. Accept. Oh, trust me, boy, I'm gonna buy you a bundle. Oh, God. Change the URL, bro? I don't know if I can. Can I? I mean, I know you guys don't like the whole brony thing, but I don't know if I can actually change that. Can I get... Thank you. Okay, so we are going to start another playthrough. Continue your journey. Oh boy. On the ground is the orb and base that you found. Okay, sweet, so I can do that as well. By the way, because we didn't chug the beers yesterday, we chugged a lot of other things. I'm going to just pop this one open to drink right now. Because, I mean, this will be no fun without alcohol, right? If I can open it without spilling it all over myself. Ah, there we go. Haha! A Bird Story will give you the feels too. I mean, it looks like it.
Bottle cap.
Mine! Okay, now everyone's gonna fucking add me on Steam. Sweet. Go to account settings, you can add a custom URL. Okay, cool. I will take care of that all later. For now, we just need to get straight into this. Up. Everyone wants the metalcore. Everyone's fucking adding me. Seen this before. Skip the character selection. Yes. You use the skip function 10 times. You skipper. Fast forward. Sweet. Okay, so now we are going to meet with... Now we are going to order some lunch. screenshots all your data. Oh, what's gonna happen when I play? Yeah, dude, the game is intense. There's Joe Shark. Oh god, everyone is. Okay, so we're just gonna invite her in. We're going to skip ahead. Okay, so we got a private number, which is pretty neat. So if we go to status now, we're good. Good. Nom 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 lunch. Oh, I wish I had lunch. This is. Well, we're just gonna. We're just gonna skip through all this. Lots of friends on Steam. Where Tatsu? Oh yeah, that's Tatsu Park. Well, I'm just gonna do something. Is metalcore popular now? I mean, I don't know. I guess. There's Vara. That we have seen before. Do that, and we're just gonna leave. I forgot if you need to give her the map on Adin 2 or Adin 3. Well, I mean, we'll figure it out sometime. Okay, that's all. Okay, so we're gonna skip to the character selection. I think it's Adin 3. Metalcore is a fur. I don't think I've seen his character. I mean, I don't actually consider myself a furry, but I am rather okay with furry art. I mean, I guess you could call me a furry of some sort, I suppose. Didn't realize you had a character. I mean, I don't really have any OCs besides my really old pony OC, which is from my younger years, which I don't use at all. So yeah, I don't actually have a fur. I don't have a fursona. He likes Kevin? No. So he's a furry? No. Okay, here we have Adin. He's a furry of the minor degree. Yeah. Finally, some fluff love. Oh, I'd adopt her if I could. Closet fur? I bet you can't guess who I am on Discord. I don't know. There are a lot of people on the Discord now, so I don't fucking know. I prefer the forehead fandom. Oh, is it this guy again? Are we doing Adin and Lorm's good ending? I'm at least doing Adin's good ending. I am not sure if I'll have time for Lorm's good ending. Have her decide. I've been dreaming of fire. But only was so adamant about fur dragons getting more attention. Okay, if these people start spamming again and, you know, bullshitting around, time them out. If they continue doing it, ban them. Just instruction for you, Night Sky. You skip and you'll have time for that too. Oh, Chocolate chip cake. Fortune cards. Skip through all this. The future. We have done all of this before, but I just want to... Particularly with the final conclusion. Care for the death, the ultimate conclusion. It can also mean many other things. Like a violent outcome of a brewing conflict or a positive resolution of a long-running conflict. But I think... Not sure if I should be worried about that. Not sure what will come, but... That was interesting enough. You get the good ending directly, so no worries. Okay. I'd pay a visit. Okay, I could try. Okay, we're gonna start reading. Skip! Fine. Yes, I want to skip ahead. Skipping so fucking much. Yo, Indigo Ryu. What's up, bro? Okay, production facility. Skip through all this. That's all. I kind of sucks that I can't actually fucking skip through this. Not go to the portal. I'm gonna stay inside and call. I'm gonna wait it out. Man, these streams are getting really fucking popular. Necronomicon, I think you remember me? Of course I do. Don't slay dragons though. Okay, she got the entry. We have seen this before. Yes, I will skip through this. Like I said, you know, she felt more like a really good friend, but... Ori and the Blind Forest, since you have the game? I should. Okay, can I ask you something? Sure, go right ahead. Oh, you went to visit Remy in the library the other day, right? How do you know that? Well, I was there, and Remy told me about everything. What do you mean, everything? Amelia. Oh. Why'd he tell you about all that? He's just dealing with a lot of stuff, it seems. Well, he isn't the only one. I actually wanted to talk with him again, but if he doesn't respond, then I can't do anything either. I see. I guess I remind him too much of her. If he knew what I know, I'm not sure what he would do. What's that? When she got sick, I often visited her. I just wanted to check up on her and take a little of the edge off, considering what she was going through at work. The night she died, I was actually with her. I actually stayed with her. I stayed with her until pretty late, but as I had to work the next day, I eventually left. It was late enough when I told her to take it easy. She told me that she was just going to finish up one little thing before she got some much-needed sleep. But only after I left did she realize that she had run out of her medication and went out alone to get a refill. If she just told me, or if I would have paid more attention and noticed, I couldn't have gotten it for her, and then none of this would have happened. And that's not even the worst of it. When she died, she was pregnant? I thought this route was gonna take it easy on me! Okay. Oh, they had already made so many plans, and I expected them to announce their engagement any day. Dude, if he found that out, I think he would have probably killed himself, to be honest. Remy doesn't know she was pregnant? He doesn't, or at least, I think he doesn't. They couldn't talk to each other much, as they had to keep their relationship secret. It's not exactly something she'd want to mention in just a few sentences. Double kill? Wow. Wow! If he knows, then it certainly wasn't from her telling him about it. This game's taking it easy. What do you dream about at night? God damn, dude. Strain the nuts. Oh, if he doesn't know, please don't tell him. Alright. I know it must have been much harder for him than it was for me, but that doesn't mean I got out of it unscathed. I lost my best friend. I blamed myself for a long time too. I guess I still do. How could I face him knowing that I could have averted this tragedy so easily? I think his own feelings aren't that different. How so? Oh, he also blames himself for not being with her when it happened. Oh, because they had to keep their relationship secret. Yeah. I see. That must be horrible for him. You don't want to know, to be honest. I think he still hasn't gotten over it. I wish I could help him. I really do. Oh, what did you do after it all happened? Well, for a while I just felt guilty. But eventually I realized there are those who have it much worse than myself. I decided to take what I had experienced and to turn it into something positive. That's when I started volunteering at the orphanage. Why just let tragedies be tragedies if I could do something to help? Well, I share the same sentiment. How so? Well, I came here hoping that I could help humanity. Well, maybe you're not just helping humanity. Here, that should do it. How does it feel? Much better. Maybe with this I can even start practicing again in a day or two. Just be safe. Of course. Oh, I totally forgot. I still had a copy of that map for her. Should I give her the map? Of course I'm gonna give her the map. I want to get her good ending. By the way, I have something for you. Really? What would that be? Ta-da! Is that what I think it is? If you think that's a map of the underground building, then yes. Wow, I really didn't expect that. How'd you get it? Let's just say I had a chance to inspect it alone, and there was no one between me and the copier to stop me. That's amazing. You know people could get into big trouble for this, right? Well, it's yours now. Do with it whatever you want. I guess I will. I have to warn you, though. What about? Well, you might have heard about the water pockets surrounding the building. Any type of disturbance could be fatal for any prospective explorers. Well, I heard about that. Is it really as bad as they say? Yes, it is. I'd be careful if I were you, or at least wait until they have taken care of the water pockets, so there is no danger if you decide to pay it a visit. Alright, it'll be a while until I get the chance to visit anyway. All my free time right now will go towards practicing for the competition. I see. Well, thanks for the help with the bandage. And sorry about cutting practice short today. I guess you didn't get to see any proper aerobatics at all. After all. That's no big deal. Your health is more important. Well, thanks for coming at any rate. Bat got map, Zelda jingle. You're welcome. I guess I'll leave you to recuperate now. And maybe I'll see you next time. Sure thing. Bye. Damn, she was pregnant? Fuck, dude. I love the soundtrack. I think we all do. That's why we have a music bot playing that stuff 24/7. Skip. Skip ahead. Because we have done this already. Then we do that. Okay, we're going to take the eggs to the hatchery, then buy it. And here we have Kevin! Kevin, you fucking furry! No! There we have Remy. mean, like I said, we have seen this already. Look at this guy. What are you, made of money or something? Recuperate. Shut up! Skip ahead. And Adine again. Hey. That must be her. Hey, Metalcore. Let me just check my status again. So, someone has been eliminated already. That is, I don't know who that is. Oh, that's Lorem. Oh, he dead. Rip. Skip to the end of this scene. Hey, it's Fuzzballs. Still no love for the fur dragons? I mean, people keep pushing me towards them while I don't want to fucking do it! No, I just wanna... Let me see. Okay, this is all basically the same. Don't skip cleaning the banana? Of course. So only the ending will be different now? Rip Lorem? Yep. And here we have the banana in the shower. She's adorbs. Okay, chapter 5. Have we really gone through this quickly? Lorem, sad face? No. Well, we are going to go with Adine, of course. I guess she's here. Are you ready? Ready for what? The fireworks, silly. I mean, we've already done all of this. So, skip! Okay, so you can't stop me now anyway. Okay, here we go. I mean, this was very underwhelming in terms of how different it was. He pulled out his gun and pointed it at me. Bananadine is adorable. Reza, wait. Why can't we just talk about this? Stream ends after this? Yeah, you wish. We just did. No, what about... Wait, you're just trying to distract me, aren't you? No, I'm just... Shut up! They're probably already on their way. I love how Metal hasn't noticed / realized anything different yet. I mean... I don't know what I'm looking for. I mean, they're all here now, instead of, you know, being cut off. But beyond that, you know, I mean, yeah. Can't stop me now, having a good time. Oh! Now he's shot me. Suddenly, Razor shot me in the leg, causing me to fall over and squirm in pain. What a bastard! My leg! Ow! I saw Razor running to the box containing the generator. He lifted it up using both of his hands before making his way towards the exit as fast as he could. Bitch! When Razor got close to the entrance, I saw a flurry of gray zipping past me with a thunderous gallop. Gallop. Gallop? I looked towards Razor, who turned around, dropped the box, and grabbed his pistol. Missed! It was Maverick, who pounced immediately. Reza fell to the ground, and before he could so much as react, Maverick buried his teeth into Reza's neck and bit down. Reza slumped instantly and didn't move again. At least he didn't shoot you in the head twice. Then Adine appeared and called out to Maverick. Why did you have to kill him? Because I'm not taking chances anymore. What took you so long? Metalcore, are you alright? Oh, he got me in the leg. Maybe there's a first aid kit in one of these rooms. Adine went into one of the adjoining rooms, only to reappear with the first aid kit shortly afterwards. He's not saying anything? Fuck. Can I do anything else? I'm not sure if I can apply the bandage. You could tell me what took you so long. Well, at first, Maverick wanted to storm the place head on. But then I remembered the map you gave me and the other entrance. We heard you two talking and figured we could surprise him if we went the other way. Well, I guess I shouldn't be complaining then, because this could have turned out so much worse. Well done, Adine. We probably should be getting you some real help. She turned to Maverick. Come on, what are you waiting for? Maybe he thinks I'm going to take the generator while you're gone. Guess you really wanted to stop Reza. My apologies. He turned and they both left. Shortly thereafter, the administrator appeared and came towards me. Izumi, you're kinda late this time too. How ironic that you would remember her name now. Besides, it didn't seem like you really needed me. Good job. Her name? What are you talking about? I'm not Izumi. Oh, the head fuckery! Stop! Oh my god, you really can't say anything, right? It's only been 20 minutes now. What's your excuse now? Dude, I am going at a rapid fire rate, okay? Shut up! The person I thought was the administrator took off the mask, only to reveal a strangely familiar face underneath. Wait, is this me? Oh no! Paradox! Stop! Stop! Oh, my head. Oh, okay. I need more beer. This requires more alcohol. The person before me had a face that looked exactly like mine, down to the tiniest detail. It was like looking into a mirror or at a twin. It was me. You understand why I'm wearing the mask now? How is this possible? It's complicated. By now, I guess you know that this always ends with you traveling back in time when something goes wrong. When I was in your position, Izumi died during our confrontation with Reza. And as all the experience from all the different attempts vanished with her, I decided I had to become the person who would oversee the next one. I didn't know just how complicated it would be. Luckily, she left a lot behind to help me, and I executed her plan just as she would. So, what do we do now? Well, with the generator still intact, we will have no trouble diverting the comet and saving this world. But I also know that you feel very strongly about executing the mission you were sent here for. You messed up so bad that you had to help yourself? Unfortunately, I'm starting to realize now that this won't be possible. What are you talking about? As outlined in Izumi's plan, I deleted the coordinates that would lead back to humanity's portal when I repaired this one, replacing them with coordinates to travel back in time to the day of your arrival in this world. Unfortunately, this means that our connection to humanity's portal is lost. Are you saying we could have saved humanity if you just didn't remove those coordinates? I'm afraid so. Then why did you do it? I didn't realize it would come to this. I just executed her plan as she would have. I can understand her reasoning for it, though. It presents an extraordinary risk. Eliminating these coordinates also eliminates the possibility of Reza getting away through the portal and taking the generator we need with them. Why not just tie them to my biometric data like the coordinates we need to travel back in time? That wouldn't be much help, because in scenarios where Reza escapes with the generator, he wouldn't hesitate to kill you to take what he needs to bypass the biometric scan and use the portal anyway. Then the only way to achieve what we want is to not delete those coordinates. Can we really take that risk? You know that if we fail badly enough even once, if the portal gets destroyed, or if both the administrator and you die, there won't be any more chances. If you have seen what goes on from the administrator side during my stay here, I suppose you should be the one to decide that. That still doesn't address the question of what we should do now, though. If we want to make this happen, one of us will have to go back and do this all over again. And what happens to the other? Well, they could stay here and live their life however they wanted. What about Adine? Oh, I wish I could stay with her. All she does for the orphans. I wish I could be part of that. I wish I could be done with this already and settle down, but someone has to go back and ensure we can reach the outcome both of us want. No matter if it's you or me, one of us has to do it. Otherwise, all those we know back home, they... I don't think I need to tell you. Yo, dog, I heard you like paradoxes? Why are you making me think of those who suffer? You'll never forget them, and if you don't do this, it will haunt you, I know. What do you want me to do? Go back in time and do it all over again? It's what we've been trying to do all this time, you know. No compromise. And of course, you want me to do it so you can stay here, huh? I will do it myself if that's what it takes. I just hoped it wouldn't have to be me. Well, don't we both? If we wanted to settle for an outcome where we just stop the comet and stay here, we could have done so a long time ago. Well, that doesn't mean that we're both not tired of this. Maybe forgetting everything again by stepping through the portal would be a boon then. Don't try to make this more palatable for me. How many times have we done this now? I don't know. Because that's what you forget every single time. This one is unsatisfying. This one is really unsatisfying. You know, it wasn't any different compared to her bad ending. And it doesn't really make me feel like anything more than just a friend. But you know, this game is weird like that. What a quick stream. I mean, yeah, we can do Lorem's good ending now, I guess. So... that wasn't too bad. I mean, it's a tiny bit of world building, but I don't think it's... my ending was different, I think. We need the feels. Stream over? No, dude. I mean... not really any metal feels? Yeah, no, it doesn't. It didn't. And you don't even know which one of the two went back in the end. And a bad no. No, I have wait, you can have a free threesome with her? Oh god. Do good Lorem last? Implied that you were more than just a friend after that? I mean, like I said, you know, this just, it feels different from the others. A little bit too much. It's just unsatisfying. Oh! After scene! Oh, what will you do now? Well, for the time being, I suppose I'll be stuck in this world. Just losing the connection to humanity's portal. How is that even possible? I don't know, maybe we'll never be able to re-establish contact. No matter what happens, you'll always be welcome here. You put your life on the line to save us, and it cost your colleague his life. Reza was never my colleague. Then what was he exactly? You know, maybe it's better if humanity never finds out what happened. Oh well. Either way, I'm glad you're here now, and I think Emily will appreciate it too. You think so? I'm sure of it. The people from the orphanage should be here any minute now. Oh, don't tell me. I'm a bit nervous, to be honest. Have you ever babysat before? Not a dragon, that's for sure. Don't worry, I'll be here with you the whole time, but you'll have to be very careful, alright? Of course. I guess it's time. Are you ready? I think so. You've seen a Dean's good ending. Decisions. So does that mean we've adopted? Or... Tissue boxes, where are the tissue boxes? You get to watch over Emily with the Dean, good ending. Ah. Okay, oh, look at this picture. Oh, this picture is good, dude. Oh, I like this picture. I really do. Okay. Well, you know what? I've done a good ending. I have done a female good ending now. I don't think I've ever had this guy's bad end before. One of you and Adine have settled down and adopted. The other you went back, you stayed there with Adine forever. I mean, honestly, that's one of the most peaceful ones. Adine is so great there, she's happy. That achievement for making her take her goggles off. Okay. Okay, that was some closure on that route because that was really unsatisfying. Okay, but I haven't gotten this guy's bad ending yet, so... Do Bryce bad end? Okay, you guys will have to tell me, how do I get his bad end? It's tasty. Now I get Anna's bad and Bryce's bad ending. Yes, indeed. Okay, how do I get his bad end? Adine, good ending is very happy. Okay, that is a bit better. Good God, I like this picture. Do not talk to Maverick about the blood. Okay, that's really easy then. Okay. Continue your journey. That's how I know which endings you have. Think you got the answer now. Okay. Skip. I think you shouldn't do bad endings last. For Anna, just don't talk about cancer. For Bryce, just don't talk to Maverick about the blood. Okay, cool. Well, Bryce, ya boy. This time, don't be a dick to the fluff dragon. No! Might even be able to do three endings. Do Kevin now! Okay. And we'll go to the production facility. I guess I don't really care. Boop, 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 boop. Do Kevin or I rename you on Discord Kevin's husband? No, dude. Like I said, I'm going to do those at the end. Fucking Jesus. Christ, you guys. Okay, Bryce. Mate. Skip ahead. Looks like Kevin has a new husbando. Fuck off. Don't you fucking change my name. Don't you fucking do that. Done. Fuck off. Quite a map, actually. It's a blueprint. It's already done. What about Lorm's roommate? Seen this before? Yes! Well, it's big enough for both of us. Bones Roomy doesn't have a path? Oh. You fuckers! Why'd you get that achievement? Should have already gotten that? I don't know! Four. Yes! Achievements were broken before, I guess. Okay, so here we go. Don't say anything, and we get his bad ending. There we go. Ipsum is one of the forbidden fruits. I guess so. Four. Yes! Yo, Bryce! Come here, boy! Seen this before? No, because I want to see that fucking picture of him again. Sure, I'll fucking help you with that. Forbidden noodle. Okay, here we go. Seriously, don't worry about him. Don't base your opinion on him solely on that incident at the portal. Do you really think he was wrong to suspect Reza when Reza went on to do the things he's done? When we talked with Emira, she pointed out that incident could have caused this whole mess. No matter his reasons, do you really think you want to defend Reza's actions like that? Bryce is gonna make you whistle while you walk, boy? Yep. Well, this sucks for everyone involved, so let's just focus on getting things done when on the job and not let it consume us elsewhere. Maybe you're right. And then the fireworks. Okay. This. And here's Bryce again. The Bryce. Oh, buddy boy. Accept that shit. Okay, that's it. Alright, whatever. The Bryce is right. Definitely. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. We go with Bryce. Scream now! Okay, here we go again. Scream? No. Maybe I can. Suddenly, Bryce was standing next to me. Now you're showing your true colors, Metalcore. No, Reza, you did. I was willing to talk this out. Alright, game's over. He pulled out his gun, not sure which one of us he should be aiming at. The 6 bullets I have in there should be more than enough for you two. I wouldn't be so sure of that. Do you think you can really do that, Reza? Do you think this is worth risking your life for? And then this, it's from humanity. Like, no, they are from me, motherfucker. Bang. Dead. That's one. There's Izumi. Oh, my first instinct was to run away, but as Bryce started charging, so did I. 4 shots? Reza aimed at Bryce. It took 4 shots before he stumbled and fell. Then, Reza aimed at me. Well, you only got 1 round left, boy. I counted them this time. And then this. He missed. Then Reza says, run, Metalcore! It's going to explode! Reza is like, ah! Imagine how much easier this would all be if the administrator just brought a knife all these times? Yeah. Gaining speed, he pushed me and I fell to the ground as he ran outside. As I got up again, I saw Bryce still lying in the same spot. What about you? I can't move. Just go. It'll be any second now. I ran as fast as I could. As I was about to reach the outside, I looked back over my shoulder just in time to see Bryce throwing himself on the box before it exploded. Nah, dude. There was a rain of small debris as I heard the walls of the building shaking on their foundation. As I made my way to the portal, I saw Reza fumbling with his gun as Maverick pounced on him. Bitch! And then the same thing. Where's Bryce? He was inside. Threw himself on the generator before it exploded. His face contorted into an expression of pain and anger I hadn't seen before. I greatly admired him, you know. I knew I couldn't trust you a lot when you came here. His blood is on your hands because he got involved in your matters. Your pointless struggles. You never were on our side. It was your fight that brought here. That he, all of us got involved here. In. Our world is your battlefield. Our people, the casualties. And you still pretend that you were just trying to help us? It was Bryce himself who asked me for help. He would have wanted to. Don't tell me what he would have wanted. He is the only reason you are still breathing. The portal is over here. I'm giving you this chance, one chance to leave. If you refuse, I will kill you. Alright. He accompanied me to the portal, never leaving my side. When we arrived, I remembered there was something they needed to know before I left. Wait, the comet, you need to listen. Suddenly, one of his claws wrapped around my neck and tightened its grip until it was cutting off my airways. I said you had one chance. One more word, human, and you're dead. Do you hear me? He let go and shoved me towards the portal's controls. As I tried to figure out its interface, only one set of coordinates presented themselves to me, which I confirmed. Wordlessly, I took my place in the middle of the portal. And we're gone again. Maverick's gaze never left me as the portal did its startup routine, and I thought about what would happen now. I considered what would happen now. I was going to be the one who would have to tell humanity what happened. That Razor was dead and I escaped with nothing but my life. I was sure the welcome I was to receive would not be a warm one. This mission had been a last-ditch effort on humanity's part to save our slowly dying city. For all my efforts, not only had I gained nothing, but I also lost the PDAs I had given to the dragons. Considering our city's failure, I could only guess that whatever other cities remained had limited time as well. At this rate, humanity was doomed. He's not paying much attention to Discord anyway. What? Yes, I am. Fuck off. Speak for yourself. I mean, I have them both on my right monitor over here, so like I said, speak for yourself. On the other hand, all of those who knew about the danger of the comet in the dragon's world were either gone or dead. Maverick would no doubt tell his own side of the story of how he stopped both Razor and I, who he held accountable for the deaths that had occurred. Maybe he would be hailed as a hero for having stopped Razor, only to be proven wrong when a few weeks later, the comet would strike. Well, that was it. I mean, flips him off as you teleport. You were ignoring this one because everyone is talking about Kevin? No, I look over every once in a while and see, oh, people are talking about Kevin. I don't really give a fuck, so I continue with my fucking... Well, that was this end. I mean, like I said, you know, Bryce wasn't really all that much of an emotional route for me. I mean, it's certainly sad. And I mean, him throwing himself onto the generator doesn't really, well, make any sense. Because, well, that thing has a rather big explosion. That thing makes a rather big explosion and it wouldn't really have helped anyway, so. Anabat next? I mean, I've only done an hour so far, so... And even less than that. So, I mean, I guess I kinda have to. You know, just to fucking fill time. This last end should be a good one. I mean, there are still other ends that I will have to do. You know, the neutral end, the evil end, the good end, etc., etc. You know, those are also still on the roster. Yeah, we have another hour left, so I mean, I guess I could. I mean, I guess I'll do that. Lorem, good ending if you're up. Do neutral and evil before true end? Yeah. Oh, what the fuck? Something's happening! Welcome back. If you haven't realized it yet, this is the day of your arrival in this world. Who are you? I can't remember anything. It's fine if you don't. Actually, this may be better for both of us. I don't even know if we've met before, or if this is just the effect of the teleportation. Either way, it doesn't matter. Come on, Remy will pick you up soon, and there's something else we need to take care of first. Ooh, secrets. What does it mean, though? You have seen Bryce's bad endings. While I'm off, hope I can catch the end of the stream, peace, Metalcore. Anabat and Lorm, good to close out the main cast, and another stream could be neutral, evil, and true last. The thing is, I don't think I'm going to be able to do Lorem's good ending. I think it'll have to depend on how long the current ending will be. So... So there we have Bryce now. Of course, we had his gallery image already of him bleeding. Whoops. Do the evil ending? How about you go fucking suck on my dick, bro? 1 hour past, you did two endings? I mean... Well, I guess we'll do Anna's bad ending then. And we'll... I'll have to see how long I have after that. Skip! Skip the Andrew until day 4 so that only should take a few minutes? That is true. Skip! And a bat is pretty short, which is mostly why I brought it up. He isn't bleeding, he is investigating a blood spot. Oh, well, I'm fucking stupid. Skip! No, someone booped the snoot too hard. Skipudes. Skipusamurudes. Since before, yes! Can I be linked to Metal Stream? You are on my stream, idiot! I would give anything to boop a Dean's nose once. That'd be fucking cute. Okay, then we have this again. Four, yes! Skip! Holy fucking skip! I boot Remy's or Lorem's? Okay, I don't want to skip this one ahead because, well, her image. You can just skip and just not mention cancer. I admit that I was selfish, always, yet I did great things. At least that's what everyone kept telling me. Oh. Maybe I won't have to die- hang on, maybe I won't have to die alone after all. I don't know if I'll be able to be there. It doesn't matter. You've already done more than enough for me. I'll remember you when I die. No, I want to see her image. And then we have this picture, which is... Okay, there we go. And we go with Anna. Whoop! Okay. Okay, so here he shot Maverick. The jaws dislodged, and Reza aimed his gun in my direction. Suddenly, Anna jumped in front of me as the deafening bangs of several more shots rang out through the hallway. Fuck! They're catching the bullet! No! While I was unharmed, Anna was hit multiple times and fell to the ground. While I watched Raze's hand dive into his pocket for more ammo, Anna's harsh breathing filled my ears. Quickly, I dove behind the generator's box for cover and saw Anna opening her muzzle, spraying some liquid in Raze's direction. Oh, you are gonna burn, motherfucker. Raze looked at her in bewilderment before he suddenly burst into flames. He started flailing his arms around wildly, trying to put out the fire. Well, I certainly know that that fire is not gonna go out anytime soon. Oh, but the flames didn't stop. He tried to get up, but failed as he fell once more and squirmed around the floor, shrieking in agony. A short time later, his body slumped and his cries stopped as he lay on the ground, motionless. I watched for a while as the flames continued burning the now lifeless body. I went over to Anna, only to realize she was covered in blood from her bullet wounds. She was breathing heavily, but was still alive. This looks bad. I have to do something to stop the bleeding. Oh, don't bother. Based on where he got me, I'll be gone soon. Don't say that. I've done autopsies before. I know how this goes. No one can help me now. You jumped in front of me, Anna. Why? Why did you do it? Well, I only had a few moments left to live. If I was lucky, that is. Anything past that wouldn't even be a life worth living. Would you want to spend your last days strapped to a hospital bed, slowly wasting away until nothing is left but a mere shell? A shadow of your former self? They can prolong my life, but they can't save me. But by doing this, I could save you, so I did. I know you have it in you to achieve and succeed at what you set out to do, even if I couldn't. Even if they'd have me rot and die in prison, then rather than finding a cure for myself and who knows how many others, just make it count, Metalcore. Before I could answer, her head slumped. She was dead. I looked around the room. The fire had stopped and it had become eerily quiet as I checked on the others. Maverick's dead. Reza is burnt to a crisp. Can't say that I'm unsatisfied with that. While I confirmed that Maverick and Reza were dead, I was glad to discover that the administrator was still alive. I found a first aid kit in one of the rooms and used it to dress her wound. After a bit of rest, she was able to get up, and we walked outside. What are you planning to do now? I don't know, Izumi. What do you think we should do? We have to stop the comet after all. So you remember my name. What else do you remember? I know we can stop the comet, but I also want to help humanity. I'd be just like Reza if I didn't try, you know? Just helping one world and disregarding the suffering of another? That's why I was asking for your plan. Sending generators now would be out of the question, since we'll need all we can gather in order to stop the comet. That is correct. Well, unfortunately, I also know that by the time we've stopped the comet, humanity will have given up on the portal and disconnected its power source, so we won't be able to help them afterwards. You remember well. Well, the solution to this would be rather simple. We just need to let them know to wait a while longer while the dragons recover from expending all their power sources to stop the comet. We could just send them a letter. I'm afraid that won't be possible. And why is that? After what happened during some of our other attempts, I decided to delete the coordinates to humanity's portal when I repaired this one a few days ago. But the portal has ways to locate other functional portals, right? We could reestablish the connection. Unfortunately, looking for other portals through space, time and space would be a significant energy expenditure that we can't afford right now. Not if we want to stop the comet. I reject this outcome. If there is no way to send them help, I will go back to the day of my arrival and try again. That's why you put those coordinates in, after all. No, that's not your call to make. These coordinates were only to be used in emergencies or if we failed. As far as I am concerned, we did fail. Look at this world and what they have achieved under my guidance. You want to jeopardize this for a chance? Just a chance? To save your city as well? It's what I came here for. Reza too, but he's dead now. So I'm the only one they have left to fight for their survival. I can't just leave them now. And nice as it would be, a life here would be a life built on the suffering of others. I wouldn't be able to live with myself knowing that I could have helped them, but didn't, because I took the easy way out. As far as I'm concerned, this isn't over yet. You want to save those who sent Reza and his supporters? Is this really about humanity or about Anna? She sacrificed herself for you, not for you to undo it all again. It is her sacrifice that makes it possible to save this world now. Is that not enough for you? No, I'm going. If that is your final decision, you leave me no other choice. Suddenly, I saw her reaching for something in one of her pockets. When it parted to reveal Reza's gun, I quickly grabbed it and pointed it out of the way before Izumi pulled the trigger. In the ensuing scuffle, I managed to wrestle it away from her and hit her in the face with its blunt end. She collapsed in pain as blood started to run down her cheek where the impact had opened a gash. As she squirmed on the ground, I turned to her before I took my leave. You know what? For all Reza has done, you sure don't seem that different from him when it comes down to it. Goodbye. As I made my way to the portal to return to the day of my arrival, I thought about what had just happened and what I would do now. If anything, Izumi's actions had only strengthened my resolve to make things right. Just right. After all, I had all the time in the world to try. And that was like 10 minutes, so... I mean, I guess we can do Lorem's ending now. At least, yeah, Lorem's good ending is the only one left, right? So we could do that. That is very possible. And I think we are. You know, in this picture, she is oddly human-like. I smell another ending. Yeah, I guess you guys do. Rename the title to Rushing the Endings Like a Boss? Do it! Do I have what's necessary for his good ending? Yes, I do. I do, in fact. Too bad you can't skip this, though. Oh, I accidentally screenshotted. Whoops! Lorem's good ending, the evil, the neutral evil, and true endings are all the ones left in the game, and technically a true ending plus. I smell Luftwaffles. Okay, so we're doing Lorem as well today. You have seen Anna's bad ending. Sacrifice. I mean, I did feel like this was more in character with her. But you know, her other ending had sort of a more satisfying feeling. Just like, you know, her just jumping on him and just slitting his throat. Although I want to see the evil ending, I mean, that's probably not going to happen, to be quite honest. Plus, you know, we're going to have to do, like, the asshole ending and stuff, so... Okay, so we're going to do it again! If hit the skip button on the last dialogue box. Okay, Laura! Hello! Hey! Look at the lack of secondary characters. Fuck off! I thought Lorne's bad ending was where he drowned. No. The asshole ending is the evil ending? No, but I'm not just gonna do, you know, one asshole run. You know, I'm gonna go through pretty much all characters and see if I can, you know, get there really, I can do some really dick moves to them. You know, say some really stupid shit to them. Do Kevin boy? No! Like I said, later! You put your assholes! With a boop, I'm fine! Yes! Skip! Fuck! I have become a pro fucking speedrunner. Forgot to know if he's enlightened right now, but should be. I mean, yeah, they're all here now, so. Oh, what characters you offended? I mean, like I said, I just want to see the response to it. Now we skip. Okay, chapter 4. Could Kevin really be considered a dragon? Could Kevin really be considered a dragon, though? Enlightened, talking about the Discord. I mean, you know, somewhat, but I still have. But you know, I am still having to do the other ending. So next run, you'll be enlightened. I hope so. And then the other ones are just, you know, basically me just being an asshole. Gives that to you. I dare you to say before you do this and tell Lorm to get out. That is one of my asshole runs. You fucking bitch. Hey, Lorm. Hello, my friend. Okay, oh, that must be the sphere you found. And then you have the round object. Yeah, maybe you can help me find out if it's actually Ipsum's or not. You'll get an enlightenment card on your next run once you do Lorm's good. Okay, sure. Sure. Looks like it has no battery, though. He turned the sphere a few times, then placed it on the base and plugged it in. You have assembled the Ixamon Sphere. Actually, it was Lorem. This should be his achievement. He touched the base in a peculiar way. In response, writing appeared on the sphere's surface. And that's one of the images. I saw the. This one was spoiled to me, damn it! Well, it looks like this really is Ipsum's Sphere. He'll be relieved to know that it was found. So what can we actually do with it now? Nothing, really, unless you know the password, that is. Well, that's a shame. I do happen to know his password, but that's only for emergencies. No playing around with the sphere then. Got it. By the way, did you hear about Ipsum? Apparently he's become a witness for a murder case. Rubbing his ball. Now open Pornhub? Maybe since I skipped the end of the scene. I mean, I have seen this, pretty much. Nothing has changed here. Okay. Okay, here's his hermaphrodite. Okay, you know what? I am going to save it here. But I'm just gonna save it for maybe the end. Like, the end of the stream. Like, if I do this route, if I have a little bit of time left, I will tell him to get out. And I'm probably gonna feel so incredibly bad and want to kill myself for a week afterwards. So this is our penultimate save. I don't mind. Like I said, that is going to make me feel so shit about myself. What I want to do? It's Hornhub? Hornhub. We go with Lorem. Cute little fucker. Yeah, I still have his little sphere. I could give it to Lorem when I meet with them. Okay, so I'm guessing that is required for the good end, I assume. Just in case. And I know that you guys like this. You like it when I fucking fuck up. We're going to take the sphere. The sooner Ipsum gets it, the better. I took the sphere and put it in one of my pockets before I headed out to meet Lorem. Oh, I also brought Ipsum's sphere. Maybe it can finally find its way home. Great. Would you mind holding on to it, though? I don't really have a bag or anything to put it in right now. Do it right at the end so I have something to drink to. It will fucking destroy you. That's alright. Just remind me to give it to you later. Sure. I think it's starting. Look. Like, wait a minute. Give me the sphere. There you go. I watched as Lorem took the sphere from my hands and slid their fingers over its interface in a peculiar way. After a few seconds, they were done and the sphere was back in my hands. It might not help you much, but if something goes wrong, just throw it at him. Alright. Wait, can that thing detonate? Cause if that's the case, that is awesome. Those are some big ass pockets. Yeah, I mean, if you look at what I wear in terms of, you know, pants, hang on. I mean, I wear these sort of pants, like these are cargo pants, and I don't think that would fit in there. Oh yeah, fuck up long time. Lorem is pretty small, maybe not that big. It would still be rather sizable. Where is he anyway? The underground building. Let's go. Like, you know what? I'm not having this conversation with you again. What are you talking about? Your plan, Reza. I know all about it. Great, then stop wasting time and help me with this. I'm not here to help you. This is where it ends. What is your problem, MetalCore? You know about the comets, so we can't stay here. Just shut up, Reza. I'm not in the mood to talk with you anymore. I don't need to, because your friend has just arrived. Suddenly, Maverick and Lorem appeared next to me. Bitch! Like, how the fuck does that fit in your pocket? I don't know. I planned this. Yes, I did. Okay, then we do this. Forget it ever happened. 6 bullets for 3 people. It belongs to humanity. Then we have the administrator. She dies. Ixman Spare Isis Gadget number 1. Now she dead. Maverick and Lorem charge! two, three. Shot Maverick until he went down. Okay. Now he kicks Lorem, which pisses me the fuck off. Remembering Lorem's words, I took the sphere and threw it towards Reza as hard as I could. At first, it looked as though it was going to miss, but the sphere adjusted its path and flew straight towards him. Reza aimed at me, but the sphere hit him before he could pull the trigger. He lost his balance and stumbled backwards before he fell to the ground. As he got up, I saw that the barrel of his gun was now bent out of shape. Yes! Yes! When he realized this, he bolted towards the exit. I tried to stop him, but he hit me in the face with the gun's blunt end and ran past me. It took a few seconds until I composed myself and ran after him. As I went up the hill, I saw that Reza was already taking his place while the portal did its starting routine. I ran up to the console and entered a few commands. Reza turned around and saw me. What are you doing? Bitch! Reza walked off the platform, but I quickly ran around the console and threw my weight against him, just in time for the portal to start teleporting us. Uh-oh. Oh no, I don't like that! Lorem lived to tell the police what had transpired in the underground building. The conversation they had overheard was enough for the dragons to find out about the comet, and with the help of the portal's power source, they were able to divert it. As neither humanity knew that, nor the dragons knew where Reza and I ended up, our visit was considered a failure. Humanity had decided that if our visit did not yield any results, they would no longer try their luck with the portal, and instead use their remaining energy to hold on as long as they could. For the dragons, life went on as usual, but for our city, this outcome meant they had to continue their fight on their own. It was an uphill battle that was eventually all lost when the city ran out of resources and fell. Okay, I hope that afterwards we at least get to see where we went. Like, where could we have gone? I don't fucking know. Maybe we teleported randomly somewhere into space and just, you know, just popped like a fucking balloon. I mean, yeah, even if you still look at the table, that is a pretty fucking sizable sphere. Like, that would at least, you know, fit in my hand like this, you know, that thing's pretty big. Please tell me Reza's not in the past now too? I fucking hope not! Otherwise, I may have to take his face and just, you know, smack it into the concrete after a couple of times. There's more after the credits? I know. I'm not fucking stupid. There's only one place you can go? Well, what's that then? I don't fucking know! There before you, so why would that matter? It's messing up the time loop? Shit, I want to play that on piano now? I may have to see if there's sheet music for it. And, you know, maybe give this a try. Perhaps, you know, give this a shot at learning this. Apparently Vlad's in the stream as well. Sweet! He looks pretty mischievous here in this picture. Like, hello there, little boy. I mean, there would be two of him. I mean, in another ending, there would be two players as well. You know, that has happened before. I think it was Anna's? No, it was Adine's good ending, where there were two players at the same time who met each other. So, where are we and what are we going to do with this guy? Where did we teleport? Where are we now? Bloop, bloop, bloop. Now tell Lorm to get out and do neutral ending? No. we reappeared on the other side and collapsed to the ground. It was the day of my arrival in the dragon's world, just as I had planned. What the fuck is going on here? Oh, look at what the cat dragged in. Woo! You're supposed to be dead! Am I now? You're right, but today is not the day. She held up Razor's head and punched him. His body instantly went limp as he fell unconscious. Good job, Metalcore. Oh, is that yours? She pointed at an object on the ground behind me. When I turned around, I realized that it was the Ixamin Sphere. Whatever setting Lorem activated had apparently prompted it to follow us, even through the portal. Not exactly. Oh, you better hold on to it regardless. Those things are expensive. She walked over to Razor's lower half and started lifting him by the legs.
Come on and help me with this. We got a long night ahead of us.
We torture him to death? You have seen Lorm's good ending. The plan. Now she hits him.
Fists of steel. I mean, that looks like a pretty tiny girl, you know?
Okay, so now we have everyone. One punch Izumi. Razor was unarmed. Yeah, so? He's a piece of shit regardless. Did you see how close she had to get, though? That is true. But I mean, if she didn't say, you know, that is mine. You know, she could have come up behind him and just sucker punched him from behind.
Oh, look at this. Oh, look at the... Oh my god, that's adorable! Holy fuck!
And now I have to go tell Lorem to get him out. That ending's pretty disappointing, IMO. I mean... And now I have to go tell Lorem to get out.
Oh. Oh! Oh!
This is gonna bring on some heartache, people! Oh! I don't want to do this one! Okay. I don't want to have to do this one, to be quite honest. Because it stands so counter to what I... to what I would say. Oh, guessing I'll have to grab some liquid courage. Hearing Metal squeal over Lorm's gallery pick. To be fair, it's super cute. Okay. I have, that's my third bottle of beer. Well, then how about you don't do it? No, I have to, dude. Okay. Lorem, I am really sorry for what I'm about to do. Please forgive me. Just for completion's sake. Get out. So that's what it's going to be, huh? Don't worry. I understand. It's far from the first time this has happened. I'll go, but let me just say this. I don't blame you. After all, I have no idea what they think about people like me in your world. I don't have a right to judge. But that doesn't mean I don't lament the many opportunities that were lost because of this. I hate it. If I hadn't said anything, maybe we could have met a few more times. Maybe everything would have been fine. But that wouldn't feel right to me. And again, I just have to wonder if those other times didn't mean anything to you. Did they? Maybe it was wrong of me to ever think that I could be your friend. I mean, you did your part. You came to my apartment and let me draw pictures of you. You told me I shouldn't worry about what's going to happen, and after that, I wasn't worried anymore. And what did I do? Nothing. And then look at the status menu. You're still unimpressed! What the fuck? I did nothing. And we're bad. My heart is aching so much. Okay, now I want to do one more. And that is the third option. I'm not sure what to say. Well, that already tells me all I need to know. You'd think it's only bullies who go after me once they find out about this, but too often, it's also been people who thought I were my friends. So whenever I meet someone, I have to prepare myself for this conversation, not knowing whether they will suddenly turn against me when they find out. And the reactions can be so different. Some get angry or make fun of me, others feel betrayed and don't want to have to do anything with me anymore. By now, I think I've seen it all. Maybe the next person I tell is going to become violent. I'm glad that you're not one of those, but it's always a gamble. How can I put myself out there when this could happen wherever I go? You know what I mean? What will people do when they find out about my game? I just don't know. That's what I'm worried about. I only wish there was a place where I could be safe from all that. Where it just wouldn't matter that this is who I am. So you could actually knock that out too? Okay, this is... Okay, so now we're gonna go alone, I guess. Okay, we're still good with him. Do I want to do the neutral ending, though? I don't think I do. I think I'm gonna quit here. Yeah, that is really depressing. Because you can tell that he has gone through this before, you know, he basically can't be bothered to give a shit anymore. Save it? No. Yeah, save it for another day. Yeah, we've done enough. We have, in fact, done enough. But, you know, like I said, you know, you can just tell that the guy has gone through this many times before, and he just, you know, he knows about it. Remy still smiles at you. Dude, don't pull me like that, man. I mean, Remy would not smile at me after I've done that. He would not. He'd probably think I'm disgusting, to be honest. Okay, that is heart shredding, like you said. But at least we've done it. So, yeah. Well, I think we're gonna do the after talk, and you know, then I'll. We're pretty much done, so go down to the description. There's a link to our unofficial Discord games Discord server. There's a link to my Discord server, my social media, everything else, and Yeah, that's the worst thing. Lorem isn't even angry at you. He apologizes even. Yeah, as if it is his fault. Which it isn't, obviously. So, yeah. Thank you guys so much for watching. When will I stream again? I do not know yet. Either tomorrow, same time, or a Tuesday, same time. I do not know yet. I think it's going to be Tuesday because I have school again tomorrow and I'm going to have to be up really fucking early and have some other stuff that I need to do. So I'm probably going to take tomorrow off. So we're going to do all the other ends on a Tuesday. And we will, we are going to finally be done with the game. At least, you know, as far as the characters and stuff goes. So, then I will finally be enlightened. So, like I said, you know, thank you all so much for watching. Like, favorite, comment, subscribe, whatever the fuck you want to do. And like I said, you know, keep an eye out. Not only on my channel, but also on our unofficial Discord server. So you know when I start streaming, and you know you can chat to me, you can chat to everyone else. You can have a lot of fun there. So yeah, like I said, you know, thank you all fuckers so much for watching. And I will see y'all guys in the next stream. Peace. Okay, so we're not ending just yet. Okay, so apparently, I think that's Maverick on the server. He wants to actually, wants me to watch the video that he made again. So we're going to do that real quick to see if it upsets me again. Which is this video right here, which is really sad. So I'm going to have to put the sound way down because otherwise I will get copyrighted strikes. So, here it is. That's even still very fucking loud, so. There we go. Sorry, copyright. It's... That is fucking sad because it basically describes what's happened with Remy. It's yeah, it's really fucking sad. So yeah, like I said, you know, we're gonna do the after talk now. I will be taking my leave. I guess Calyx can link it to you if he wants to. So yeah, it's really cute. And the first time I watched it, it actually really somewhat upset me. It's like, and then, It feels. But like I said, okay, so now we're actually leaving. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you fuckers in the next stream. Peace.